electromagnetic field is very important for the electrical engineers. How it's an important means all the electrical applications, whether motor or generator, these are the main applications is working, is running under the electromagnetic field only. What is the difference between electric field and magnetic field? If you can see the electric field, the electric lines are originating at the positive charge and terminating at the negative charge. So here our question is, why the electric lines are originating at positive and terminating at the negative charge? Let QT testing charge will be taken as the positive charge, then the electric lines are originating at terminating at the negative charge. Let Q of T be the negative charge, then the electric lines are originating at negative charge and terminating at the positive charge. How can we conclude these lines are what? When let Q of T is the positive charge, if we should bring this positive charge to the positive charge, then these two are like poles, repulsion to each other. That's why these electric lines are away from the positive charge. Next, the test charge will bring to the negative charge. The electric is attracting according to the electromagnetic principle. So electric lines of force is attracting. That's why this direction is from positive charge to negative charge. Whenever you have taken test charge will be taken as the negative charge, then the electric lines are originating at negative charge and terminating at the positive charge. The next one is, come to the magnetic field. How the magnetic field is generated in the world? The magnetic lines are originating at North Pole and terminating at the South Pole and passing through the magnet, and finally it's terminating to the North Pole only. Once again, say the electric magnetic lines are originating at North Pole and passing through the South Pole and terminating at the North Pole only. The, because of this, the reason the magnetic lines are representing as a closed loop. The electric lines are just originating here, and so they have, based on this electromagnetic fields, they have given the concluded four Maxwell's four equations. The first equation is purely electric field. The first equation was purely electric field. The equation we are representing as del dot D is equal to rho V. We'll see one by one why we are taking this del dot D is equal to rho V means is only it's represent. D means electric flux density. Electric flux density means the amount of electric flux passing through a particular area is called as electric flux density. Rho V is the volume charge density. These both are densities only. This is a volume charge density. The charge is distributed on the volume. How this equation we are coming in is in according to Gaussian's law. This law states that the amount of electric flux, total electric flux enclosed in a path is equal to the total charge enclosed by that path. Total electric flux passing through that path is equal to Q, is there in that Gaussian's here. The total charge enclosed by that path, Q enclosed, is equal to d phi, the total flux in that path. So based on this one, they have given del dot D is equal to, if you can simplify, del dot D is equal to rho V. Why we are taking is three dimensions means the current is passing through a conductor. Conductor means is a cylindrical coordinates conductor. So the cylindrical coordinate conductor will be a three dimension. Three dimensions means is a single dimension length, two dimensions length and area, three dimensions length, area and volume, it should be taken as here. So similarly, if you can take in the pure magnetic field, is this also given by based on the Maxwell's equation only. Del dot B is equal to zero. Del dot in the Maxwell's first equation, purely electric field, del dot D is equal to rho V. In the Maxwell's second equation, del dot B is equal to zero. here where B is equal to B representing magnetic flux density, the amount of, what is the magnetic flux density means, the amount of magnetic flux passing through a particular area is called as magnetic flux density. It's representing the units is Weber per meter square. 1 Weber is equal to 10 power 8 magnetic lines. Here our question is, you can observe in these two equations, one is purely electric field, another one is purely magnetic field. In both LHS and RHS, you can observe in a both LHS, delta dot D, delta dot B, divergence of electric flux density, divergence of magnetic flux density is there. But RHS, here we are considering the value is rho of V, but in here we are representing 0. Why we should representing as a 0? This is our question. Means it's based on the standard principle. The electric lines are not terminating. It's originating at one end and terminating at the negative charge. But here the magnetic lines are originating at the north pole and terminating at the south pole. So if you can take at any point on this magnetic flux line, magnetic flux entering to the point is equal to magnetic flux leaving to that point. You can take any point here. Magnetic flux and flux entering is equal to the flux leaving. So the net flux is equal to flux entering minus flux leaving. So both are same. Then the net flux is equal to 0. Because of this concept of this closed loop only, the RHS value should be represented as a 0, delta the net flux is equal to, but here is also in the magnetic field itself, here we have applied magnetic Gaussian Gaussian law, the total flux entering to the point is equal to the resultant flux is leaving to that point, the net flux is equal to 0. Next, here Ampere's, one more important law is Ampere's circuit law. Up to this point we have discussed only purely electric field and purely magnetic field. Now next, Ampere's has given the relation between electric and magnetic field. What he has tested, when the current passing through a conductor, what he has observed, the current passing through a conductor, it develops a magnetic field. How he has find out this one, the current passing through a conductor, in this conductor he bring one magnetic needle towards the current carrying conductor, but in this what he has observed, always north pole towards the towards this conductor. Based on this one only, he has concluded that every conductor is producing a magnetic field. Due to this magnetic field only, the magnetic needle always the north pole towards this conductor. So when the current passing through the upward direction, the magnetic needle is, it's the current passing through this one, the magnetic lines are representing like this one, or otherwise the current moving downward direction, the magnetic lines are in opposite, it's a right hand principle. So the total current enclosed by that path, this is the relation he has given, Ampere has given, this is the current I enclosed is equal to the closed loop integral of, this symbol we are representing, closed loop integral of H bar dot dl bar, magnetic field intensity due to the electric field intensity. This is an electric field to the magnetic field. Next, in the last one, the Maxwell's fourth equation has given the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. He has given the relation between magnetic, this one is electric field to magnetic field, this one is del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. This was given by the Maxwell's fourth equation, Faraday's, according to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So totally four equations is there in the electromagnetic field. The first one is, the first Maxwell's equation is del dot D is equal to rho V, is a purely electric field. The second Maxwell's equation is del dot B is equal to 0, This is a purely magnetic field. The third one is del cross H is equal to J plus J sub X D, which gives the relation between magnetic field to electric field. The last one is del cross E is equal to minus dou E by dou B by dou T. This is an electric field to the magnetic field. Okay, these are the four Maxwell's equations.